Hey guys, welcome to the installation of your LIAN LI Galahad AIO. First thing we're going to do is we're going to take these 12 long screws. We're going to use them to install your fans on your radiator. The way we have these fans going in right now is we've got them pulling air through the radiator and exhausting out the back of the fan. It's a setup for having it at the front of your computer. If you're going to use it at the top, you may want to think about doing an exhaust setup, in which case you would just flip these fans around. Now that we have the fans installed, we're gonna worry about getting the pump block onto the motherboard. We're gonna grab our bracket that's labeled with a LGA1700. We're gonna pull these two adhesive thingies off the top. Kind of a pain, but you can pull them off, and that way when you go to apply it to your motherboard, it should just stay there. It makes it a little easier to install it by yourself. You don't have to worry about losing it when you're putting your motherboard down or anything like that. And we're just going to lay our motherboard down right on top of it. Next, we're going to grab our four dark colored mounting screws. There's, at least in the package we got, there were darker colored ones and lighter colored ones. We're going to use the four dark ones. We're just going to start them off on each corner, and then we're going to evenly apply pressure to each one of them. Now we're going to take our thermal paste and we're just going to apply it on our CPU. Careful, this stuff did kind of seem a little liquidy. It kind of shot right out of there. Be careful. Now we're going to take our pump block. We're going to remove the plastic film covering the cold plate. Don't forget to take that off, because if you do, you're going to run into some thermal issues. You'll be troubleshooting it for days, and then when you go to RMA something, you'll pull that off and realize you didn't take your plastic off. Now when we go to line it up, we're just going to put it so that each one of those screws goes through a hole in our pump block. And we're just going to use these thumb screws and start, you know, get all four started with your hands, apply pressure, and then use a Phillips head later on to make sure they're all nice and tight. These ones are spring tension, so you can apply a little bit of pressure with these without having to worry about over tightening them, which is nice. Next, we're going to take the 3-pin connector from our pump. We're going to hook it up to our SATA power connector. Well, you got two options. You could hook it up to the SATA power connector that comes in the box. This will allow your power supply to just power your pump without having to do anything else. If you'd rather monitor it in your the BIOS in your motherboard or something like that, you could always just unplug it from the SATA and you could just plug it directly into your motherboard, either your CPU optional, your pump fan one, something like that. And you'll be able to just monitor it right in your software, which is nice. Next, we're going to plug in our fans. We're going to take this PWM splitter here. It's got three inputs for your fans. We're just going to take each of our fans. We're going to plug one in each of those. Obviously, the 240 and 280 mil versions are only going to have two fans to plug in, but this is the 360 version, so it's got three. And we're just going to plug each one of those in. We've got, it's kind of a rat's nest here, as you can see, but we're going to plug all three of them in. And then our last thing we're going to do is we're going to plug in the actual 4-pin in the motherboard. That's going to go into your CPU fan header, just like this. You're just going to plug it in, and that alone will allow you to control all three fans right from your BIOS. As far as controlling your RGB goes, they send you this splitter. It's going to have two or three inputs depending on the size of your radiator. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the proprietary ARGB inputs from your fans, and we're just going to plug all of those into the splitter. And now we're going to take another splitter that came in the box. This has a input for a 3-pin and a 4-pin. And then we can hook that up to this controller that takes SATA power from your power supply. But for now, just take your 4-pin ARGB proprietary thing from LIAN LI. You're going to plug it into the 4-pin. We're going to take that, and we're going to plug it into this controller here. And now we're going to take the 3-pin connector from our pump block. This will allow you to control the ARGB on that with this controller as well. It only has 3 pins. You're just going to plug that into the only thing where it should fit. And now we've got this dongle here. This will allow you to control the modes, the lighting, and all that stuff. It takes a little 2-pin that has a SATA connector to it. And now if you plug that SATA connector into your power supply, you can use this controller to power the ARGB on 3 fans as well as your pump. So if you don't want to do that, you have another option. You've got this thing. It hooks right into your motherboard. It's got the same 3-pin and 4-pin headers as the other. And basically you connect your fans into the one that has the 4-pin, and you take your pump fan or your pump connector and you plug that into the 3-pin. And you could take this 3-pin ARGB, it's J Rainbow or something like that, and you just plug that into the 3-pin connector on your motherboard. And if you download the LIAN LI software, you should be able to control your ARGB through that software. And last thing we're going to do is remove this plastic film from the pump block, and your LIAN LI Galahad should be installed. If you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing. If you want us to keep producing content like this, it would definitely help us out. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you guys next time.